You try new things. Now, Killer Joe, as I said, I gave a quote for the movie, called it, it'll fry your eyeballs off.
That's a good one.
Never seen. You've never seen a movie like this.
No.
Why did you take the role of a Dallas police officer who's a sociopath and a contract killer?
Yeah.
Why?
Well, let me tell you, the first time I read it, it disgusted me. To the point where I just put it down, didn't want anything to do with it, wanted to go take a hot shower with a steel brush and clean myself off, like a tough weekend in Vegas or something. You know? And there's a woman I work with, there's a few people I work with whose opinion I appreciate, who had read it simultaneously. When I spoke to them, they were howling laughing. And they're like, you didn't think it was funny? And I was like, no, what was funny about it? And they pointed out a few things, and they pointed out the writing, Tracy Letts' writing, the meter. He's a whole different meter of his writing, that you have to really sustain sort of silences that are natural to the characters but are unnatural to someone like you and I having a discussion. And I gave it a couple of days to flush it out of my system, and I sat back down with it with an open mind and I guess a different, I had my funny bone turned on. And I did find myself chuckling. And I found the humor in it, and I found the humor in the absurdity, in the deliberate provocation, in the sort of cheerfulness, in the amorality, in the, again, the levitated realism of it. And that was understanding Tracy Letts' writing. And then also after a sit-down, one sit-down, like we're sitting down here with the director, Billy Friedkin, 1 hour with him was the most clear I've ever heard a director be. Of exactly what he saw this film
as being. This is the man who did The French Connection, he did Exorcist. Mm-hmm. He's not a young man. He's back, huh?
I don't know if he ever left, and he sure as hell is a young man, though. He may be up there in years, but like yourself, he's kind of grown in reverse or never left younger years. As far as energy and intellect and eyes open for new things that are happening in the world and new experiences and seeing opportunities is kind of the first time. Billy's right there.
You want me off the job? Say the word.
When are you planning on doing it?
Tonight.
Really? Well, so you'd be leaving tomorrow then?
No. The retainer's for the money. I'm not leaving until I get my money.
I don't like that.
Well, I don't care.
I don't want you near my sister.
I don't care.
Killer Joe opens on the 27th. How do you think it's going to do?
27th. So we're going to, a couple of people are going to go see this little film called The Dark Knight. A few people will go see that.
Well, that's the week before, I think.
That's the week before. They'll still be seeing it, though, that week after. We're going to open, we're going to do it in a traditional platform. We're going to open in a few screens in New York, and then we're going to go wider to different markets. We're not going to be 3,000 screens in every single multiplex. It's not really designed or it has the DNA to be that way. But we are wearing NC-17 as a badge. And we're not running from NC-17. We're saying, oh, hell yeah, we're NC-17.
Oh, you are NC-17.
Come get you some real NC-17. And, I think it's gotten wonderful word of mouth. Critically speaking and online, people are absolutely kind of blown away by it in many
ways. There's some scenes in this you have never seen in a movie.
There's some scenes that have never been in a movie. There's some that I don't even know where Tracy Letts, where his mind goes at 3 in the morning, you know? But it's got a lot of good shock value, and it's done well.